from American Horror Story Freak Show. This is a scary, creepy clown that kind of got a little bit defected. I got a nose right there and a nose right there. My mouth continues farther than it should. This is the American Horror Story Freak Show. Welcome to the show. Make sure to check out my brothers and sisters, the Blind Fortune Teller and the Bearded Lady. They're all fun characters. And now, enter our circus. Thank you for coming by. Today I'm doing the last character from the American Horror Story Freak Show, and this time I'm a creepy scary clown. As you heard in the intro, you can see that kind of I started growing out another mouth and a nose right here. I thought it would be cool than just the classic scary clown. I got this colorful wig. What's awesome. I'm going to be talking about the details in the video. Thank you guys so much for watching. Don't forget to like, subscribe, share this video if you did enjoy it, and leave a comment below. Tell me what other character you would like to see. Let's begin. Hi everyone. So first let me tell you what you're going to need for this tutorial. Any clown wig. You're going to need fake nails. You're going to need surgical tape. You're going to need some very good sturdy scissors. You're going to need tissues. We're going to need liquid latex, spare gum, wax, and so on. This is a very challenging clown. I wanted to take it to the next level. Okay, we're first taking a white pencil. I'm using my Sigma Beauty Inner Rim Brightener. It's called Unclouded, not clown. And I'm going to be marking where the mouth is going to be. Okay, that's gonna be like the mouth part right there, as you guys can see. The nose of the clown should go like right there. So all of this in white is going to be 3D, okay? Now the next thing I'm gonna do is I'm going to be taking these fake nails. If you want your clown to be a little freakier, like it looks like he doesn't have even lips, even teeth, then you can cut a little bit of the edges. I'm going to be applying a few of the teeth over there. So this is not a lot of space. I'm going to be using the smaller nails. I'm gonna be taking the surgical tape and I'm just gonna measure. Okay, like that. The nails which I just cut, I'm going to be nailing onto the tape, as you can see, at different lengths so the teeth look a little bit freakier. I'm going to be folding this over just to make sure that the nails do not move. So this is what it looks like close up, as you can see. And then we're going to take more tape, tape it over this again, and then tape it there. And then I'm going to repeat the same thing for these lower teeth right there. Now I put the tape right there, and then we're going to tape it right there. Okay. I'm going to be taking my nose and scar wax, and we're going to be doing a gum texture. Picking up some gum, some wax. Quickly through your hands, by spare gum, right where that like tape is, right on the tape. And then you're going to take this, the wax, you're going to apply it right over. Okay, there we go. You're going to be taking a spatula and then just blending it over like this. There we go, right? And we're going to repeat the same thing down here. When we did that, I'm going to be taking my liquid latex. I'm going to be applying it over this. Why are we doing this? Just so that we kind of make a little coat over the wax so the wax doesn't budge and move. Okay, so while this is drying, I'm going to be taking spare gum, an unwrapped cotton ball, and applying it around my mouth to get the mouth texture. So this is what it looks like. I applied the teeth later on and I just pushed them underneath with the same method, but I didn't apply the gum here. We already have enough texture like from my lips so that the teeth are pushed out. Look at that. And then later on we're going to be coloring in the details. That is much later. Now the next step is apply liquid latex on these cottons, on the cotton ball or cotton swab. And then if necessary, I'm actually going to apply a very thin coat of tissue. So tissue and liquid latex over this, or just liquid latex, you could try it. But I think it's going to give a nicer texture with at least one layer of liquid, of tissue and liquid latex. So This is what it looks like with the liquid latex and so on. What's really important is to actually set it with a setting powder so the latex has something to adhere to. The thing is to take a cotton ball and we're gonna be applying it right there. Spirit gum, make it tacky, and then apply. And then you're gonna go with liquid latex and tissue over it when you are done applying it. This is what it looks like when I applied a liquid latex and then one layer of tissue over it. We're going to remove any of the excess. So we're gonna let this dry for a little bit, and then when we're done with it, in the meanwhile, I'm going to go and cover my eyebrows, and then I'm gonna come back, and then this should dry by then. If you wanna see how to I cover my eyebrows, you can click right here. There's going to be a link to the tutorial on how I cover my eyebrows. I've covered my eyebrows, I've let this set. What we're going to do, I'm going to be taking my RCMA white foundation, and I'm going to be applying it on my entire face except this mouth area. I'm going to be working on the details. I'm going to be using my Coastal Scents Creative Me palette number 1. I'm going to be using the purple shade right there, and I'm going to be setting this purple which we just applied. This is what it looks like when I set it. You don't have to worry about it being neat because you are a scary clown, so. You're done with this. What we're going to do right now is we're going to set the white. Now I'm going to be taking a matte black eyeshadow and my Sigma Eyeliner Brush in EO5. Wipe off any excess. And we're going to enhance these lines. With whatever is on your brush, just draw, outline those lines. Same brush, we're gonna be shadowing with what's left over in here so that my eyes look like they're much deeper than they are. It's going to give a much deeper depth and it's gonna give a spookier effect, just like that. Same brush, pick up a little bit more black just with a light coat and outline the rim of the mouth. Now we're gonna be picking up a red cream foundation, and we're going to be using my Sigma Concealer Brush in F70 or anything smaller. I might be using a smaller brush later on. We're going to be outlining the rim of the mouth and the nose. And then when we're done with that, we're going to be setting it with a red eyeshadow or a red pigment, whatever you guys have handy. Going to be applying a pink foundation on the rims right above the teeth part so it looks like you know, your natural gums of the teeth, and then we're going to make sure to set that. All right, so after we're done with this, I'm going to be working on a little bit like shading, and so it looks more 3D and so on. You can also apply yellow eyeshadow, a little bit on the gums and a little bit on the teeth, so it looks a little bit more worn out. I was thinking about this and I was like, you know what, I'm missing yellow. Okay, for the last thing, you can apply the nose, but since this nose looks dramatically bigger than this one, so I'm going to be coloring my nose red. I don't have a red. I'm just gonna use the pink, which I have from before. Red eyeshadow. Make this look freakier, I'm just gonna take a little bit purple, apply a few dots on the nose. It's going to look like I have really big pores on my nose. All right, everyone, this completes the look. Don't forget to check out smashingbeauty.com for all the product lists and details. Thank you guys so much for watching my last American Horror Story inspired character, a creepy clown. I just want to say thank you guys so much for watching. Don't forget to subscribe, like, share this video if you enjoyed it, and leave a comment below. Tell me what else you would like to see. I will see you soon. Bye, guys.